heading off up the Weipa Road now, after leaving Cooktown about an hour ago. Stop for lunch. This is all Land Cruiser country, isn't it? Hello.
Hi.
Basic history of rock. This area here, there's a couple of Aboriginals that are still Laura originals in the little town, they're two old ones. They've told all sorts of stories about this stuff, and some of it contradicts the stories they've told previously. And whether or not they just don't want to rain wind on it. So the engravings, they have recorded back to about 12, 13,000 years. So if we say 10,000 years, 10,000 years ago there were people living here. I mean, probably, I don't know why, I guess it's a nice place to die. The turkey here and a few hand stenciled paintings. There's actually a long sort of snake thing up there with all little dots on. That's an eel. So we get freshwater eels down in the rivers around here. Well, the Laura River's not running at all at the moment. And there's just a few water holes in it. Right. There's a little lizard here. A bit of this has faded away. Some turtles down there. A yellow one and a red one. I don't know why that's a yellow. The only reason I can think of is that this is a different type of turtle, of course, because you can see his head. If you go down into the river here, and even in the dry season, you get where there's a bit of a water hole, you go down even at either end of the water hole, and you look along the side of the bank, and you'll see find a nice sandy area where it's sandy. If you look along it, you'll see little indentations like where rocks have been. You know, the water swirled around it. You get a stick about so long, nice and straight, and you bury your stick down there. You'll eventually get a turtle, and they get down there and they hibernate under the sands.
And I'll show you some more artwork tomorrow. At one site we've got imaging down the bottom, and then we're going to do a circuit right up the top, probably 3.5 hours, right at the other end. And when we get the other end, imaging's white. Right. So in that space, that's where the children were made to roam. They were protected. The eyes painted on there, she may have done something bad. She may have killed somebody. And we don't know for sure what happened. But that may have happened a long, long time ago. Long-necked turtle again. There's also another one underneath there. See how it's going on the side? Pokara. See the feet? And a long tail. And a long snout.
That must be
the freshwater pokara.
Thank you.
think that's great. Check it out for us. That guy's got those funny, funny eerie things too.
They didn't have that in the inside.
Was the weird thing up
and the one over the right looks as though it's been done with crayon.
Yeah.
That little bit over there.
The weird thing up in Kakadu was seeing the sailing ships.
Yeah, we saw the sailing ships and there's one thing which we can see.
Red rock.
We didn't find many Aboriginal Albion.
No.
Can you get round there?
Stuff on the ceiling here, but it doesn't look genuine.
The Quinton of Imogen or whatever it is.
Lovely, isn't it? That's in
one leg though. Here's a nice, something a lot bigger.
Magnificent ones up at King Edward River that had ant nests being, not so much.
Two big tea bags, so you can share a tea bag.
With, we'll be right.
And we've got sausages, haven't we?
Oh, yes, the sausages.
Also,
a commentary, if you like.
Now you're about to see a spirit.
Opening
in the rock. It's about to hit its stony elbows or knees on the ground and make thunder.
Oops.
Yep. Thank you. Bill to keep on going.
That's where we were down there with the jellyfish engravings. There they go, one up into the sunset.
Filming there, dear.
I just walked back, had a look at the smoke. Now we're back in the gallery. We've got the stabilizer on, I hope. An old campsite in the gallery. This is the cave you just walked into.
Yeah, I don't mind watching as long as you sit down.
But that is a wonderful
look at the tree above you there, darling. Take my photograph there.
Oh, there's something. Oh, no, it's a leaf.
Oh, I think I'll find
it. Was a snake.
Oh, yeah, and you reckon I'm the cow? Because the wonderful lizard attacked me. And you laugh. That's beautiful, that tree above you.
So we can pretend we went there.
We could walk back the other way, but... Yeah,
it's a bit of a risk. It's 10 to 5 and it's...
We've got an hour's flight there. Have you got a map on that road, Joe? No.
There was... No, we looked.
But...
There is on...
So far. We've been doing
a couple of... Very intermittent, though.
We could have done it now.
I think there's probably another 2 hours of walking.
Yeah.
We've still got a bit of sunburn today.
Don't use your knees. No. You've got bloody scabs around the dinner table tonight.
Done that.
Oh, look at the itchy bitsy pieces on top. I could probably add another bit and make it even bit higher. The balance of it.
We're up to 59 minutes and 38 seconds, and there's the car way back down there with some more dirt road in the distance.
And some fire as well.
Yeah.
Fire
and the car's down there. There it is. I think that's scrubby.
No, it's okay. There are lots of ledges. No, there aren't any. Not really.
Oh, Terry. I'm going to close my eyes.
I'm not going to look at Bill.
Oh, Bill. That fall off.
Yeah, recording. Recording now. Recording
last
the top.
Moments of Bill and Mary.
Yeah, it's on top of the mountain. It's split rock.
Is it finished yet?
This is called
Lover's Leap. Lover's Leap, okay. 1, 2, 3, leap. It's actually a vertical drop there on the other side. Well, it's certainly...
It actually is quite a long way down
there. There's a
there.
Bath here.
Well, it's good.
This was probably quite sacred.
This is our campsite just across from the reserve we looked at. We just have to watch out for crocodiles. This is the great Aussie barbecue.
What's that video again?
Yep.
Will I turn the headlamp on?
No, I think that would have an adverse reaction. Here comes Helen with the dinner. And the crocodiles are just over the back, aren't they?
I think half.
Right, that's for defending ourselves against the crocodiles. Wave it around. Yeah, just wave it around a bit.
I'll give you a demonstration.
Just whack Helen about the backside.
Get out of here! Get out!
Yeah, good. Right.
Get out of here!
Don't go too far away from the
that's
fire.
Okay. Did you get that?
Yeah, got that.
Yeah, that's how aggressive I can be.
The crocodiles are just behind me. We've missed the sunshine.
Yeah, waiting for the sunrise.
Right. Okay.
Yeah, I've got some hot
So you've got the rake there, haven't you? So
yeah.
And I'm getting the water.
You can beat the crocodiles away with the rake. Now if you fall in now, I'll get it on candid camera.
Yeah, me too. Hang on. Just before you fall, just time it so we can photograph it.
Down to one beat a minute or something. And see, look, there's a bubble gap there now. Yeah, really slow heartbeat and really slow, look at it, Bill, you're filming those bubbles? Good.
They're moving towards Terry.
Yeah, they are.
It's not nothing big.
As we all come close.
And there's
Mary's got nice pink toes sticking out of her thongs.
It's so clear. I mean, if there's a crocodile here, to be...
You'd think you'd be able to see it.
Actually,
see
that... Leaving our first bush camp at the crack of 10:35.
Starting to gather dust.
The odd oil leak from the CVs.
And wrap the front up to stop stones bouncing off back in the rear window. our lunch stop. We're still working out where we're hanging everything. We had one white water jerry can, like the one on the roof, on the front of the trail, and it fell off and dragged along under the ground for a while.
Table hand.
Yeah, it's our table's right here. It's just tied up here in the back. You have to undo the knots that stopped it bashing against the rear window.
You'll have to do it because I can't kneel on my sore knee.
You have a red rear wheel.
I said to Helen a while ago, turn the headlights on because the red car is even turning redder, so nobody will see us.
When you came over that crest, did you see us? A couple of k's ahead on the road.
Yeah, but then somebody else passed as well, so I don't know whose dust it was. I think it was
frosted. This is a little billabong for the crocodiles. Look, he's just flicking his arms, look, his fingers. There they go. The three just walking away. There's the vehicle with Terry calling on the CB. Where are you? There's the airstrip that Terry and Helen just saw the plane take off from. Here's our campsite just out of Cohen. That's the track down in the sand. We backed and filled and manoeuvred our trailers over here. And Helen's just rigging up, has rigged up, got the engine going for their inaugural shower. There we go. There's their washing in the riverbed. It flows in past Cohen. The engine drives the shower. That's the loo tree, is it?
That's the loo tree.
Morning, yeah.
Yeah, it's, the toilet's on the other side. It's a very,
must
very
get that washing out because
it's
a
very.
I wonder what all that black stuff is in the water.
Probably soot from the.
There's Mary having her shower. Beside the Cohen River.
Not much of a shower, Rose.
All the ladies having their showers. The washing machine just bolts on there, but it nearly fell off yesterday. It came unwrapped and was dangling off on the dirt road.
Take that camera off. It's folded up.
In this old video, I'll take you to it.
Here's Nelson. Here's just a girl. Yours is different to ours.
You can find that bomb up here
after.
The top goes over to the bottom. That's step one. Right. And then you hold that there while these go in.
These go in.
Yeah. No, but you don't twist this up.
Can't stop
the top has to, no, the top has to stay there. So the top.
You have managed to do this before.
Yeah.
Andy did it once. And
Andy did it twice.
And Bill did it once.
Very exciting.
Now you hold those two together and twist the others in. And then the sides squeeze in. And cross each other over or something. No, you don't twist that bit.
Look, I had an idea, Bill, that maybe open it out and let it fold up in a different fashion. And from, no, open it right out again. It might have folded up the wrong way the first time. Like the side coming in, maybe it needs to fold back on itself. Back the other
why
way.
Why don't you go and help him, Dallas?
Just swing it right around, back on itself. Yeah. Maybe that's his problem.
I'm trying to make two small circles.
You want some help?
The top's one circle.
Have another go, darling. You have a go. Helen's done my house a couple of times.
You go and give him a hand too, Terry. This is good filming.
It's going, look, look.
Hang on, a rock with it.
It's going there, I can see it. It's looking good. It's looking really good, Bill. That's...
Back, back, everybody.
Don't force it.
I'm glad this has got steady cam.
There we go.
Can we share your tent next time?
I think, yeah. I want to have another go. I want to have another go.
It's not different from yours. It's getting bent a long way.
Now you're putting it back to like it was before.
Yeah.
That's what it is. Remember you said, Shane?
Why has it got some twisted? Well, I think they've bent it. One of the earlier proportions. What did you do with yours?
Because the difference is that with ours, you can't see.
This is quinking. Now walk away.
This is shaky cat.
Maybe I should get ours out. Well, I get ours out and we'll have a look.
Let's just see how it is. It?
No. I think the quint and
fast. Helen, just stand a little bit further over to the thanks. How do you zoom?
Is that in?
Yeah.
I'll get ours out. I'll get ours out and have a look at it. By watching, you might be quite good.
There's probably not in that.
It's Fran.
Fran is.
That's right, yes.
That looked easy.
That's right, it's folded over in the... Terry, you try ours.
But I've tried.
Yeah, but what you did...
Just go and do that to that.
And then the sides twist in. Hold the bottom, put your foot on the bottom.
Pull it back.
And the sides twist in.
Fairly deep and rough at the bottom. That's been cautious on all of them, really.
Sorry, but the message is up front or out of range.
This is Archer River. We're having an Archer burger. There's a cattle truck just come in. All the cattle are mucking about. They're trying to settle down in the heat. There's a friendly guy here who told us about all the travellers coming in like they were going to work and didn't have time to stop and chat and kept nearly running each other off the road. Here comes one now. Poor things. Some of the more intrepid travellers. Back to the Archer Burger. These are all the Charlies that dash past us. There we go, all this. And they're all sitting here wondering what to do. There goes Terry in the dust. Terry's just looking for a camp spot on the Archer River. Window behind me closed. It was actually opened a bit before. Oh, it's towing up. a long trail. He missed us. Okay, just keep going along there at your own speed.
What you doing, Bill?
It's just levelling the trailer. We just sunk down a couple of inches.
You realise you'll have to dig out the whole lot because the tent's going to be too high then.
Alright.
No, a little bit more.
Dig down to a campfire, see?
Right. That might be okay. But where's your spirit level?
There's a campfire.
Is there? Is it a light?
No. Our first beach campsite.
Well, no, second.
Well, this is a good last sandy night. Beach.
Yeah, last night.
This one. That was beach gravel. There's a flood level up there, 4 or 5 metres above the cars. And up here, a couple of metres above me.
We've got some water in the thermos too, if you want a cup of tea.
No, I'll just drink another litre of ordinary water. Cold water, that's going down quite nicely.
Where's my chair?
Oh,
I don't know, you didn't.
You're the worker.
Mine, you
got to earn. You got to earn your rest.
This is the flood level, a couple of metres above my head. I'm several metres above the river. Down there, this is early morning, I've had a swim. And we've all had our cups of tea and toast. And the flood level is back up here. And the vehicles are down here. And that log in the tree is about my eye level. There's the river below. I've got the zoom on about a 1:1, so it's natural eye zoom level, so I can see stereo through my left eye, and I can see the log with my right eye. They're both the same scale. It's about 3 times zoom. With both eyes open, I can pan around and see in stereo. And there's our camp below that sand dune, which is built up by the Archer River against a number of boulders just next to the vehicle. Yep.
The automatic washing machine.
All the washing hung out, waiting for the sun to come out again. No, you just go in, please. Hurry. Aren't you in a hurry? No sound effects?
No sound effects yet, no.
So what's in the news?
Now what's in the news? Well,
so you're not going to use the newspaper, you're going to use the toilet roll.
A couple of days ago, a fellow was taken while he was sleeping beside the Yohan River.
That's the great thunder box.
Behind you, you can register.
After you.
No, you go first.
No, I don't want to go first.
Our first bog, just watering the sand, just leaving the campsite.
He's built. moving out of the first bog. Perfect.
They stopped at Charlotte's Crossing. Have a look at the desolate crossing. The pole's not vertical. Most of the red, I think, is from the road.
Big pools in the shade of those trees up there, and nice little freshwater crocodile. That'd be a nice place to sit.
Nice place to sit.
I think we're not going to. They're not going to find us as freshies. We've got to go look for them. All this beautiful green new shoots coming up all through here. Lots of green coming up after a fire. Lots of the vegetation struggling against the dust from the traffic.
Doing a little dance.
Near the tree is a pandanus that we use for a silhouette. That's where we watch the sunset. This looks like the part of the all the quarters for the construction workers of Comalco, Weipa, when it was first developed. There's a couple of acres of this. Fairly desolate bit of coastline here. The old coconut here growing. We're keeping a good lookout for estuarine crocodiles. This is where the locals come down and do a few wheelies on the beach. A few of them have trouble getting out. They end up filling up the holes with corrugated iron. Stockpiles, they're loading one of the ships. There's the, what do they call it, going out?
Sorry, on the conveyor belt.
Conveyor belt. Got frame and digital stabilizer on now. Out there, 250 a second, 12 times zoom. Now I got that frame on 350th of a second. Frame on and digital stabilizer on. I think they're still in bed. Oh no, there's Mary up. 8 o'clock. Barbecue. We haven't been there yet. The sun might come out again in a minute. We're just focusing on the crocodile now.
The bird in front.
Yeah, that bird. It's a tempting fate or what?
We found out up in the Kimberley a lot of birds did that. When they know they can.
He's yawning, isn't he?
Yeah, he's just got his mouth open. They can't be mouth. How big is he on the 120 zoom?
Photographic genius to work on.
Yeah, luckily the crocodile stayed there all the time because I was fiddling with all the settings.
It took him a long time to fiddle with the settings.
I was just filming
the 120 zoom on the video camera, but when he got to 120 it pixelated. So what did you get? How big is it?
That's the smoky fire that came through. Some people go to more extreme lengths to have a look at a crocodile close up. There's a crocodile just down left of that beacon, and the people are just across this bit of water. Back here. This is around the point from where we had our little drink, due west of where we were, about 100 meters away. This is a Aboriginal midden, or part of it.
You'll notice about these houses, first of all, they all face the same way, and that's to pick up the prevailing southeasterly winds. They have louvers on either end until it gets to a stage where it fills up, and finally it will overflow and run out into the sea. Average rainfall here is, his mate obviously feed him off or whatever, anyway, they got away, and he's in hospital in Cairns. The thing about that though is, I mean, 15 metres away from a crocket, can mine it out. Well, quite simply, all we would do is in the wet season, we'd come along with dozers, push all this timber over, put it into windrows, and we will burn it. A lot of people say, gee, that's a waste of a lot of... Back to the profile of your land, and you will remember that the layer underneath the bauxite's the ironstone, and that's what you're driving on here now, and you can see that it makes a natural rain base. It allows us to mine this whole operation right throughout the wet season, so it is a 12 months of the year mining operation.
Ha ha ha.
difference between regeneration and the tetradonta forest is how thick it is, and the Southeast Asian economic meltdown creates tons of kaolin for you. Here's your water table level again on the left, look. Pure fresh water. Now you may be wondering why we got this one. 330 tonnes of machinery having a head-on collision at a combined speed of 126 k's an hour.
Okay.
The operator's got out there. Down into another crusher, onto the belt beside you, into the plant that's gone. Control. This used to be a majority-owned Australian that we were just before. That's quite dusty. In other areas of the mine, it's not quite. It's just a different amount of fine. It has lesser impurities. They put it through the refining process about halfway through, and they call it a sweetener. So once a month, we go over to Amdoom, and we mine 400,000 to 500,000 tonnes of trihydrate. And we only just come back last week. He's got a set of stop and go lights up there. Told you it was exciting. Eric didn't fit into the secondaries. It's the machinery that's vibrating. That's a dewatering screen over there now. See? Nothing but a whole bunch of little balls. Both those stockpiles rotating furnace fire at up to 1200 degrees centigrade. The heat burns out the impurities in the water, and out comes the grey material. It is used for sandpaper, grinding wheels, grinding paste. We supply the world with 48% of its requirements this year. That is 140 furnaces, and I think it's a great spot to throw in a couple of chooks. And up here on the left, this is the biggest ship that we load here. He's now taking high tide. He'll take the next high.
All the scrub, they're just burning off on the other side of the road. We just stopped, we're a few K behind the others.
Stop.
Can't see a thing now.
Take off in a second. The kite or the road? There they are. Get it just shot and left. There's a good one.
Oops.
Sell it,
yeah.
But
and you know, I mean, we're
and it's strange that we've just done it.
weren't the solicitors been in at then?
No.
We just had to stop here for shots of anthills. I won't be able to go in and get a close-up. I think there could be lots of snakes. But this one, that's end on. And here's one side on. Here's an edge one looking north. This is looking east. These are some of the smaller corrugations. You can do them about 70k over these. Drop the firewood. Thank you.
Yeah. I think Al's fairly deep in.
I thought these chairs were cold when I got up this morning. They're now warm. How far in the water did you get through this last night when you were coming in?
I took a photo. Hear the shutter?
Does
yours have that?
No. Right, now we're in record mode using the remote. I'm just backing down into the crocodile infested river. Hi. Now I'm going to film myself being taken by a crocodile.
It's a high tide mark.
Thank you.
figure up on the... He's coming out.
They like the soap, don't they?
Oh, yeah. Well, I like doing it because I've sort of learnt since then that soap can be the big one down there.
I find out and take it out of the freezer, because that's quite large. It'd be good to get it out of the freezer.
So what's happened, Terry?
Oh, I don't know. It's bulged out at the bottom, it's got a crack in it.
I mean, that's only wood burning. It's not as if it's been, you know, it's in a blast.
First time we've used it, huh?
A lot of things are...
The Aussie oven melted its bottom. A weight problem.
Oh, there you go.
We're fully aware of our natural beauty.
Dead wildlife.
We did that many years ago, and we actually had them converted, the good ones, to prints.
Yeah, we must have done and
gone
through
them. A lot of them had mould on them. We're troubling
with them. Well, we're really lucky because it gets developed. You don't get mould in Canberra.
I still won't leave there.
But we're going to have to scan them now
to
get the digital.
I'm sure you're getting, talking about like 3,000 or something.
Here you go. Go up in first!
wasn't that at all. Now, Barry doesn't turn around.
Oh, you go ahead. You want a whole...
You're not going to fit your whole body in there,
eh? No, I was going to pour a bucket of water over me.
Oh, yeah, I would too. I just poured...
Oh, yeah, you'd love to do that, could you? Put that...
This is the bit they just came up.
Mother can't see your feet.
Enough, Phil.
Yeah, that's all it was.
It's all done.
He needed
once they get over that lump.
Yeah. Half a car length, all he wanted.
Just checking out the change in scenery.
Road just north of the turnoff.
Wait, we're getting the shade and then start filming.
I'm filming.
Wait, oh, are you?
Yep.
Oh, hang on then. Oh, what? Stop it.
Okay.
I think we should walk across.
Not this one. Oh, a bit hard to film.
We'll show it to them on the video. Nice little valleys. It's like the Nullarbor or Arrowsmith River. Just step up on the... That's right.
It makes a better picture.
See the corrugations here where the... Now just kick, you just kick it back, you see the corrugation. They're just soft.
Yeah, very soft.
Yeah. But these are only little corrugations.
That's if you want to go on.
No, we'll wait. When you get here, you'll see why. Over.
Okay.
A little cocksure of himself, that's for sure. We couldn't believe our eyes. We thought, heck, what are we coming across?
There's a group of about 10 four-wheel drives that just come across the river crossing, going past our campsite. Here goes another one, just past Owl's tent. This is some of the excavation that the four-wheel drives do. One crossing, two crossings, and the third one just there.
which they all came up this morning. They camped over the other side of the river with generators, etc. This is the loo at Bertie Creek. Okay. That's the thunderbox, the real bush thunderbox. Looks like some sharpening grooves there in the river.
Boys always hold on to their penises, don't they?
Hey?
Little boys always hold on to their penises.
I'll have to edit that out, Terry.
What's that?
I'll have to edit that out now.
I'm sorry.
Especially one of them. A bit worried about it. My growing up, I think.
He's dying. Give me something.
My mum was saying she took them to sleep, basically my baby. Oh, right. Looking down here and that's lovely.
Just, well, they were the ones that went across the creek just before us, yeah.
Where did the other one go?
Thank you. cut him.
There was still photo.
What?
Photo of him.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
He wants to take photo of the falls.
The light comes on the dashboard when you, actually fills up with water, and I just start
to come easily. I didn't want to touch that wall over there in the trailer.
Alright, we just had lunch and we just moved the vehicles into place now. Then some of us are having a swim and the rest having a cup of tea before we make the next big decision. There's the decision makers. There are people down there just surveying the river crossing, making the decision to go across while we're having our cup of tea over here. Nearly. Put that pole up. It's lovely hoop pine here. The afternoon light. There's a generator across the river at the Aboriginal station. We should be reasonably quiet here tonight. There's our bed.
Just setting up camp. I'm drilling out the cupboard, put in another wheel. There he's checking nuts. And they're telling yarns over here. Now we know why you've got the gloves on, you see.
That's it, yeah. It's quite tacky, isn't it? Push that board in there.
Oh, you turned that down, didn't you?
I'm the roughest looking lady in the
camp. I am stirring now.
You're stirring the...
Oh, you want me to stir in this direction?
That's right. Well, busy yourself over this side. This is next morning. What day is this? Monday.
You know, he's just taken a totally different track. But he climbed up onto those two ledges.
Morning rush hour. This is Cockatoo Creek, our first real and long crossing, but it's only 50 centimetres deep.
Okay.
they are. They're
watering.
These people here don't seem to be able to believe that we actually stopped to enjoy the scenery and take photos. They just want to get through and get on. Looks like a cane toad that didn't make it to Cape York.
Yes.
Just to take your mind off the frog. There's an ant eating this one.
And then over to your right, firmly and more. Look at those little thorny things, they're pretty, aren't they? Where was...
No wonder the honey is after them.
Water come off?
No.
Try that one.
That one's a bit weak.
These are the ones I just parked next to, leaped out of the car and didn't even notice.
Okay.
This is the creek that we came around. Mary videoed the vehicle coming through. They're going to replace these pipes, I think, one day with these.
Thank you.
We're careful we didn't pull off the road too far. There's a trailer in here with broken springs.
So we might follow on.
Those crossings where you take all the water up with you. And here's the left crossing.
Yes, ally, I locked my wheels, low ratio came up there.
Near Elliott Falls, just configuring our trailers and campers for a couple of nights. That's all the firewood for tonight.
Well, I don't think we'll be having a fire now.
Oh, yeah.
We camped on top of it. Let's just move her. Bill, help me with this.
This is below Twin Falls, just some rapids and a little swimming hole. This is just around the bend down from the Twin Falls and flows off down to Elliott Falls down there in the long pool we swam in this morning.
Oh, don't tell me he's lost one.
No.
No.
That's it.
I'm not jumping
yet. Good.
No, I'm not jumping yet.
No, well, I'm... Please wait till we...
Watch the camera, Al.
I'll go and hang on.
Go and help.
Fruitbat Falls.
corner of the thing. Yeah. Isn't it fantastic? Isn't it amazing? We've got those really comfy chairs.
Been up there to pick these up and put them in. Yeah.
I think it's wonderful.
We've got five or six working on it.
Yeah.
Usually we have a marquee thing over that, but we didn't put it up this time.
Yeah. We actually, I don't know whether we saw your lot. How long have you been on the road?
This is about day 8 or 9.
We've been on the road. Yeah. No, it must have been the
load before you. Okay, gang, get to work there. Start picking up the tents.
Hey, do it all. We're going to get the damper out and have a fiver of it for a minute.
Oh, right.
Okay.
Oh,
I'm too blind to go.
Now you got to keep to the right. Back. Keep
that was
right
actually back. All right, Al. And Bill was right. We've got a bit more wheel travel, so the wheels didn't get.
Oh, that's a trailer, Al.
You're right. See, it's not getting wet at all, June. It takes a long time to start up, Bill. Yeah. I had it on, I thought, and I turned it off.
Yeah.
Mm. No, no, no. Nah.
Little crossing up there, we're going to drive across and after our cup of tea.
There's a sun view and the sun directly below the sun. Bill?
No, that way a bit further. Righto, now that, straighten. Well, stay in that rut. This way, Bill.